Welcome to episode 8 in the Bitwig Studio Basics series. Today we're going to look at audio editing within Bitwig. My name is Mattias and this is Morning Joe Media, and let's go! Okay, so audio editing within Bitwig Studio. We can create an empty audio track by pressing Command, Shift and T. Or you can use this button up here, which says Add. Press the Add button and then you can select which type of track you want to add. And you can also pin these functions to your toolbar menu. You can see now we have an audio track button up here. Okay, but I have this empty track in our arrangement view, and I will begin by adding a sample. So now we have an audio clip in our timeline, and we will actually begin by soloing this sample. And initially, if we play it back, it might sound strange, as you can hear. That's because if I press this sample and we look in the information panel at the left side, we can see that the mode of this sample playback, of this audio clip, is set to stretch. And sometimes you want this to be unstretched, you want the raw playback mode. And it will play back the sample just untouched by any type of time stretching. But on the other hand, you can also use the other playback modes. Maybe we can take the Spectral Elastic Pro mode, which will preserve the transients for spectral stretching. And now if we play back this sample, we can hear that it's, since the tempo of our track is set to 80 BPM and the tempo of the playback is set to 161. It's sounding a bit weird since it's playing back the sample very slow and we have these artifacts happening. Then what we can do is adjust the tempo of the playback, this time stretching playback tempo, and maybe make it playback faster, or just slightly faster. So in Bitwig, if we want to explain the whole hierarchy of an audio clip, first you have this audio clip level, which is the most zoomed out level of your audio. And if you press it, you can see we have this audio clip down here too. But you can also see that Bitwig explains that we have audio events, which is the second level within this audio clip. And then we have stretching, onsets, and a few other parameters that we can adjust for the audio events. So if we go back here to audio clip, or audio events, we can chop up this sample within the clip. And to access the knife tool, you can press 5 or you can go to this menu. Usually it's a good practice to just remember these short keys. So 5 for cutting, 1 for the regular pointer tool. And then you have time selection and pen and eraser. But 5 to cut, and then we can chop up this little audio clip at different places. And now we have 3 audio events within this one clip, because you can see that the clip up here is untouched. So that's very good to understand the difference between the audio clip level and the audio event level, which resides within the audio clip. So here we can further do some manipulation. Maybe we want to adjust the fading. This is a fade, automatic fade. In the beginning of an audio event, you have a fade in, and at the end of the audio event, you have a fade out. And if we press one of these audio events, you can see that we already have a little fade at the end of this audio event. But maybe we want to fade in the beginning of the sample, and you can do that in the information panel just by dragging this fade-in parameter. And then you can also select which type of curvature you want for the fade. And when you are editing down here, you can also adjust this curve just by hovering over it and adjusting the how you want this fade. And if you select up here, you can adjust the length of this fade. And the same thing goes for the end of the sample, where you have this, where you can have a fade out too at the audio event. And that is good if you want to avoid clip peaks that can occur when the sample starts, if it's not starting at the zero offset in the waveform. So there we have our little assembling coffee machine playing back. Now we can also further make adjustments here down at audio event level. We can cut this up a little bit more. And then we can just select this clip, this event, and then press Command and D to duplicate. And it will be duplicated at the same length as the audio event. So as you can see, we are doing all these edits within audio event, and it will not be visible up here as any cuts, like you can see down here. Here you have audio clip cuts and duplications of audio clips. So that's the concept of audio clip and audio event. And we have more stuff that we can do down here in audio event level. We can go to pitch and make pitch fades like this. You can see this amount of semitones at the left side. You can also zoom in to further see the different points. Maybe you just want to pitch four semitones. Then you have to zoom out so you can see more clearly. Hello, Sigge. Maybe we want these repetitions to go down in pitch. And maybe you also pan them a little bit differently. And this one will have a little pitch up. Now we can also time stretch our sample, since we selected a stretching type of audio playback method. So you can do that just by hovering above the end of your audio event. Then if you drag it, it will compress it. And if you drag it to the right side, it will expand it. And you can see, if I drag over other audio events, they will be overwritten. Maybe we can just duplicate this whole audio clip. Now we have two versions of this audio clip. And let's make a little change to this second. Here we just drag this first sample to stretch. So there's quite powerful tools to edit your audio very quickly in Bitwig. And now this is actually Bitwig 2.5, and we have some new functionalities to edit audio. And one of them is holding down Command while hovering above either the clip or the audio event. And now we can actually just move this audio event back and forth to place it exactly where we want it. Let's see, we have this fade in, and let's remove it. So that's a few ways that you can adjust audio at audio event level. But how about audio clip level? Well, you have the same tools. You have the pointer and the knife tool. So let's just chop this up at clip level. And now we can further move this around. And we can also add fades at audio clip level, like this. And now if we select this audio clip and look at the waveform below here. Let's see, here we have it. And there you can see this this clip fade will be applied to your audio events too. So you can see if I drag it to the left here, you can see that the waveform will change at the audio clip level too, audio event level too. And we can also pitch certain the whole clip if you want, and you do that in the information panel here. So let's set this to minus 12. Maybe minus 24 even. And maybe we want to move this second part back a little bit too. And adjust this fade in so it's more snappy. Yeah, and we also have automation for audio clips. And if we expand the automation lane, we can see that we have, if we don't have any plugins on this track, we have the mixer volume, pan, mute, and send group automation that we can adjust. And we can also add midi lanes, but we probably don't want to add midi lanes to our audio track. One of the subscribers, Alexi, asked me in a previous video how you go about and find all the available CC parameters for an instrument. And if we go into this clip, the polysynth MIDI clip, and look down here at the show note expressions, you can see that we only see velocity, timbre, pressure, gain, and panning. But if we want to find the other available CC parameters, we have to go into the automation lane here and press this little arrow, and we will see this pop up with polysynth and all the parameters for the polysynth, all the parameters for the reverb and the mixer, and we can add MIDI lane. And here you can select which type of MIDI CC that you want to add. So we can add expression CC11 and press OK. And now we have a MIDI lane for CC11. So that's how you find different CCs for a MIDI track. Yeah, so that's if you want to edit your 808 basses in Bitwig, it's just very simple. You just drag in your 808 sample, which sounds like this in my case. And then we can go into the audio events within the audio clip and just make our pitch adjustments as we want them. Yeah, so here we have a little beat that I compiled for this video with some of these audio editing techniques applied. Most of the time when I'm working with audio, I'm working at the clip level because it's the most zoomed out level, and it's just very easy to cut up samples with five on your keyboard and then drag these around and place them as you want them. And if you want to duplicate a set of clips, you can just press Command D and it will double the length of that selection. So now we have this. But of course, sometimes it can be useful to go down into audio event level and really be specific and create these micro edits. And if you want to reverse a clip, you can just select the clip that you want to reverse, go up here into the menu, the toolbar menu for clip, and select reverse. And I've actually tabbed this function to my toolbar because I'm using it so much, so I can just use this icon and press reverse. Okay, so what do you think about the audio tools available in Bitwig Studio? I think there's really some solid and powerful editing tools to make micro edits and to be able to reverse samples very quickly. We have to remember that in Bitwig we have the audio devices too that can really help to manipulate your audio further. So the samples in this video are from my Found Sounds sample pack and the Producer Essentials pack. There's a link in the description if you want to check out those packs. If you don't have a Bitwig yet, don't fear, because there should be an affiliate link in the description and there's also a discount code. Now you can continue and watch my next video. Thanks to all the new subscribers and patrons, and I appreciate all the kind comments on these videos. Okay, so see you in the next video. Bye bye!